Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman. It's Azure Friday. I'm here talking about Kudu and Azure Web Sites with David Ebbo. So we've seen service hooks where I could be informed that some source code has done something and then Azure can take an action on that.
Right.
But when the deployment happens, what kind of hooks can I plug into that? Or maybe tell someone that it occurred or take an action?
So yeah, we have a new feature which we're calling Web Deployment Hook. And what this feature is about is setting up a hook such that Azure will basically call that URL, make a request to some arbitrary URL when it's done. And the nice thing about that is that there are some sites out there, and a good example is Zapier, that are directly really designed to handle this kind of scenario. And the way those sites work is that they have two main concepts. One of them is a trigger, the other one is an action. So in this scenario, your Azure website becomes a trigger. The trigger is like, okay, your deployment just completed. And the action can be any of the many actions that they support, which include like standard things like posting to Twitter, Facebook, sending you email, phone, SMS, all those things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so Zapier is like a workflow, a generic workflow engine. I could say every time I post to Instagram, put my photo in Dropbox.
Yes.
And you're saying that Azure now can enlist in that. I could send pictures to Instagram if I wanted to when a deployment occurred.
Yep.
All right, well, let's plug something in. I've got an application here called smallest.net that is comes from GitHub. And when GitHub deploys it, it shows up here. Let's see if I can text me when a deployment occurs.
Okay, let's try that.
So where do I have to go to make that happen?
Well, you would first go to the Zapier site.
Okay, so here's the Zapier dashboard. And I could say create a Zap.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to load up here. And I see trigger action.
Right.
So, in this case, here's a list of triggers.
Right. The trigger is going to be Azure
lots
websites.
And lots of choices.
Yeah, but they have a nice search box. You just type like AZ and you'll...
All right, there's Azure. Okay, so when Azure websites... when this happens...
And we only have one trigger today. We may have more later, but today, like, basically a deployment is
when
the trigger.
When a deployment happens. Okay, that's cool. When a deployment happens, let me see. I'll just type in SMS. Phone. Phone, call me or SMS me. That's nice. Okay.
Okay.
Select an Azure account.
So here you'd want to actually connect to a different one, because that's a different site that you had tested with previously.
Okay. So here it's saying I need a deployment trigger URL.
Yes, so that's something that you will find, in fact it tells you will find it on the configure page under deployment.
So deployment trigger URL.
So you literally just copy this thing and paste it into Zapier.
Okay.
And continue.
Hit continue.
So now it's kind of hitting that URL to make sure, you give me one that works.
Says account is working.
Yes.
Continue. And then it takes my phone, which I confirmed with Zapier earlier.
Okay.
Cool.
So this is about filtering. Is if, for instance, you wanted to only perform the action if the deployment failed or was successful or the message contained a string, you know.
Okay.
So we can skip that for now and say we'll do it unconditionally.
All right. Congrats.
Yes.
Your site deployed.
And look, it's telling you that, you can click on this blue thing to actually get some fields.
Okay, and this looks like our Azure account. So this is information from Azure.
Yes, that's right. So there's a sort of a schema that comes with an Azure deployment, a little payload that contains various fields, and you can arbitrarily use it in the message.
The message is, then hit continue.
Yes.
And then it says I could skip it, but so this is enable my site deployed.
Mm-hmm.
Spell that wrong. Make it live. Okay. And I won't share that. So now that exists.
Yes. So now it's ready to go.
My site comes from GitHub. So this is kind of cool. We're going to see all of these services collaborating together.
Yes.
So I could go in here and make a change. Or I could go back over here and just redeploy.
Yeah, we can shortcut it. I mean, if you were to do a git push to GitHub, it would then go to Azure, which would do all that. If you want to shortcut it, you can simply take a previous deployment.
And then redeploy.
And then redeploy. You could go to a previous one.
I don't want to mess up my live site.
Oh, okay.
This is a real site that people count on.
Then no.
Yeah, exactly. So it's going and deploying that.
Yes.
So just like GitHub would call Azure, now Azure can go and call someone else.
That's right. And this is something that happens at the end of the deployment, which is how we can know the deployment status. So before it starts talking to Zapier here, it's going to fully do the deployment.
Okay.
And then it calls Zapier.
So it just said that deployment is now
active.
Yes,
and in fact, if you look at the... there we go.
So I just got a text, and it says, congrats on your site deployed, Scott Hanselman. The message is license. And that's because I had just updated the license for my website. So that actually worked. That's pretty cool. So you've got deployment URLs, and you've got service hooks.
Yes.
Kind of making complete circle with Azure Websites and Kudu. It's Azure Fridays.